Hi guys, how are you today? Arina Shevchenko is here, your Facebook visibility coach and marketing strategist. Okay, so today in the video we are going to talk a bit about business Q&A on how I made my first $1,000 is in 3 days. It was totally organically, and I'm gonna share with you what I did and how I did that. If you have questions, make sure you post the questions below, and I will be answering this your questions. So at the end of this call, you will be able to take this information, you know, follow the same steps and create your low cost and sell it out there and get the same money. Hey beautiful, how are you? Happy to see you here, guys. Thank you so for the hearts and for the love. Make sure you introduce yourself and tell me like quickly who you are, what you're doing. And like I said before, I'm going to share with you guys how I make my first, when I just started running my business at the beginning, how I was able to make first $1,000. And you will learn as well. Let me quickly share this video with my Facebook group, Savvy Action Tech Entrepreneur, so more people will join us our call. And if you have questions related to this topic, if you're something like you want to repeat the same strategy for your business, if you have questions, you're welcome to post the questions and I will be answering all your questions here. Totally free, business Q&A, nothing, any kind of attachment, like nothing pitch. I'm not gonna pitch anything. I literally here just to share with you value how I did that, so you will be able to do that the same. Okay, let me share it in our Facebook group. 1 second, guys, and we are going to start. Okay, then, hold on, ladies. Perfect, we have some people joining in. Awesome. You're glad that I'm doing it today? Yeah, today is Monday. For those people, by the way, guys, for those people who don't know me, guys, every Monday on my Facebook business page, so here is, we are in our Facebook business page. Every Monday on my Facebook business page, I create the videos, and I actually release the video when I share with you tips and strategy how to grow your business from literally from scratch to the six figure. And so if you don't like my page, make sure you click on the like and make sure you mark it as the C first, because then you will be able to get all those videos and totally for free. For some reason, Facebook, some kind of glitch going on Facebook, and my video that's supposed to be coming today, it didn't show up. So I decided to do this business Q&A for you. And because I received so many questions about when I share specific strategy, how I make my first $1,000. Hey, beautiful. And I get so many questions, people was asking what to do and how to do, so I decided to do this business Q&A. So before we start jumping in and talk about answering your questions, let guys talk about strategy that I personally did to actually make my first $1,000 with a low cost product. Your low cost product is something that, for those people who don't know, that low cost product is something that you create very low price and you sell it out there. I personally, when I started running my business about like 5 years ago, right now I already have experience ever since working very well in my business. But at the beginning, I found that because I had so many blocks, mindset blocks, I was kind of new to social media. It was hard for me. Hi, Christina, how are you today? It was hard for me to make those sales. It was hard for me to come to my potential clients and ask them, you know, what they're willing to buy from me. For a couple of reasons, because you guys, if you know me, if you new to me right now, you can hear that I have strong Russian accent and I have so many, you know, blocks on my way to ask people for the money. So this strategy was really great, working for me, very awesome. So what I did at that time when I started running my business, I didn't really have money to hire, you know, like Facebook ad advertising. So I had to do everything organically. So I make all the sales totally organically using Facebook groups. So what I did, because I didn't really have money to create the courses and sell my courses, or I didn't have money to hire, you know, at that time, one-on-one coaching, what I did, I actually, guys, everything what I had at that time, I know who my ideal clients, and I know that what kind of service I could provide to them. So what I did, actually, the step number one, I went to Facebook groups, where are my ideal clients out there. And in my Facebook group, I create the list of the service that I can provide to my potential clients. And I was asking my clients that, potential clients, and I asking them what kind of struggles they have related to those specific topic. So for example, if we are talking about the funnels, if lots of people, like, they know what is passive income, they know what is funnel, but they kind of struggling with, you know, what's put inside of the funnel to make sure that people go through the funnels and people buy from you. And so, for example, in this case, I would be going to Facebook groups and I would be like, hey guys, you know, for example, I am Facebook group visibility coach and I help people to set the first funnel. What kind of questions you have related to the funnels that you stuck with, what you need help with. When you're actually asking people, Carmen, how are you today, my beautiful? Well, thank you. So, and what happened when you actually go into Facebook groups and totally post the questions, pitch-free questions, because lots of time you go into Facebook groups and you will see that, you know, sign for my stuff, buy from me, something's like pitching, people pitching. And so when you come to your potential clients and you ask your clients, literally asking for help totally for free, they will be more open for you if you try to pitch something. And so what I did, I created a post and I say, hey guys, you know, this is, like, for example, back to funnels. So this kind of, you know, my service is, this is what I'm helping the clients to do whatever they need to do. What kind of questions you have, post this below and I will be answering. It's totally pitch free. I'm just doing here research. And when you position that way, lots of people will hop in and lots of people will be more open for you than if you would pitch it. And in this case, what I did, I actually got all the information that I needed to make my first sales. So I knew what kind of struggles they have. I knew what kind of problems they have. I knew what they want to learn because they all answering for me, like, post the questions out there. So I was answering. I figured out where they are and where they want to be. And the second one, I kind of knew what kind of language they use to describe their problem, which is the copywriting, very, very important. And especially in my case, when, you know, my English is not perfect. So copywriting was a big deal for me. And so I saved that post on my to-do list, I would say like this. I saved that post on my to-do list and I went to create a PDF. And in PDF, I basically describe everything what you need to do about the funnels, A to Z, everything, like from A to Z, covering all those questions that people were posting out there. And then when it's time for me to promote my stuff, I went to the same people, those same Facebook groups, and I used the same language that they were describing the problem, but I was using the same language to tell them, like, hey, I have the PDF, and if you are interested, this is what you're gonna cover, this is what is inside of that PDF, and if you are interested, let me know. And because, first of all, I did great research, I figured out what kind of struggles my ideal clients have, because of that, and plus, because I actually use the same language that they use to describe the problem, because of that, I actually get lots of yeses. And what happened when I actually create that PDF and I post it out there, then people say, yeah, I'm interested to get your PDF. And in my post, I was actually putting that the PDF, this is the strategy that I personally use. I say, like, for first 10 people, I will sell the PDF for $17. And so, for example, for those, the second 10 people, I will sell the PDF for, I think I bumped the price to $25. So first 10 people will get 17. The next one, 24, the next 10 people will get $25. And because that everybody will want to, obviously, I created urgency. And people like, wow, I'm willing to pay $17, then $25. So yeah, give it to me. And I get those like $10 sell, 10 people sells like almost immediately, within probably an hour or so. And so when you create that urgency with your price, basically you create the price and say, hey, for specific time, for specific people, number of people, here is how much it will cost. After that, this price will cost. And after that, the price is bumping. So what happened, I actually start selling my PDF for $17 and I put the price until $49. So I bumped the price every like 10 people, I bumped the price. This was working very great because, like I said before, because I was positioned that the way how they want me to position, I use specific language that they want me to use. And I was promoting organically in Facebook groups. And in this case, because it was organically, so I get those first $1,000. It was more than $1,000, but I get those first $1,000 within like a couple days, almost immediately. It was really cool. So guys, if you have questions right now toward to your business, if you can, you know, how you can implement this strategy, post your questions below so I will be answering your questions, okay? And right now, if I would be repeating the same strategy, I would be doing the same, except I would create two posts, and the second post I would create on my Facebook business page, and I probably would use my messengers, Facebook Messenger bots, as well to boost the post and kind of make it organically out there. I would definitely use Facebook Messenger bots to spread more about that. I have done prices that just not the last part. Well, that was like in my case, because I create that urgency part, like you want to save the money, be that one of those 10 people. Well, it was working great. Another thing, guys, what the question came for me that they were asking me, somebody was posting on Facebook and they were asking me how was I was promoting and why people will come to buy from me. So I create the strategy before I was start promoting that. First of all, I actually create the strategy and I was like, hey guys, you know, I like that. I create the strategy, figure out what my audience want, and I literally deliver on that what they wanted, right? And this is the first part. And the second one, I was building my visibility. So basically for a month or so, because in my case, at the beginning when I just started running my business, I was afraid people to ask for money, ask for sales. You know, it was not something that comfortable for me. And so I was afraid, and because of that, I was show up in the same in those Facebook groups, and I literally was just delivering the value. I was literally just create the post, like, you know, like, for example, back to those funnels, like, you know, this is why you need funnels. This is the top mistakes that people make around the funnels. So I was actually create the post related to this topic for a couple of weeks. And of course, guys, I always recommend teaching you all the time. Always make sure when you deliver the value, make sure you post a picture of you. The same like if you go into our Facebook group, Savvy Action Tech Entrepreneur Facebook group, and then you will see that post when I actually can describe for you what to do and how to do. And then you see the picture of me. So this is exactly what I did. I actually put the picture of me, created visual aspect, and I also delivered the value. And because, first of all, because the post, when you deliver the value, it's people like it and they will, they leave the comments, it's automatically post will bump it up. And when the post is bumping up, people see, more people see your picture. At the end of the day, because it's so much noise on social media, you want that people start recognizing you. And in this case, make sure to post the picture of you, because then, you know, that creating that recognition much, much faster. So that's what I did. I actually went to those Facebook groups and I was actually literally just deliver volume. And I was building this non-lock and trust factor. And after a while, I decided to kind of take a step forward, and I didn't even expect that I will make that much and that fast those money. But yeah, I create the post. I ask people what they wanted. They give me what they wanted. And then I create another post and say, hey guys, if you're interested, make sure, you know, let me know. And then I went to my PayPal account. I create my invoice in my PayPal account, and everybody who were interested to purchasing from me, I just send them, redirect them to my PayPal account, and they were purchasing from the PayPal account. And when you set a PayPal account, you can actually, it's a button out there, so you can actually click like a check mark and redirect them to, you know, to your purchase. So that's what I did. I create just PDF itself, create PayPal account. Everybody who purchasing, it's after them, redirect them to the purchase. How much group did you post in? At that time, I never recommend to post more than in a few groups. So that's kind of, guys, what I do mostly. Like, I would recommend for you to create a list of the Facebook groups and be consistent out there. I found that if you come to the group and you never, you know, you never active in that group, you will look like a spammer, and mostly it's end up that admin will kick you out, which is you don't want to. And so I was 3 or 4 Facebook groups. I was active out there because at that time I was working part-time on my job, so I didn't really, you know, have time to spend more time than other Facebook groups. But then I was active in those 3 or 4, I think it was like 3 Facebook groups, but I was consistently active out there. And because I was consistently active out there, people will kind of see me and recognize me. They knew that if Irina create the post, that means something good is going on out there. So that's why my post was usually really great. Oh, you're so welcome. Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, you literally give the value. I always say, like, treat others like you want to be treated, right? So how many of you want that somebody will come to you immediately start pitching? Nobody wants, right? But if you actually give the value, and we guys all give the value anyway, we create the blogs, we do the videos, you know, we go into Facebook groups and we create a post out there, we're always consistently giving the value. So it's, I don't see the problem why people say, like, okay, well, you need to consistently pitch it. No, you need to build a relationship with people, because of social media, it's so much noise on social media. So position yourself as an expert by giving the value. And in my case, this is exactly what happened. I was positioning myself as an expert. People see from me lots of value. And when I create the post and ask them, like, hey, what do you need help with, you know, to specific topic, and then I just took all the questions that they have, and I literally create the PDF, and of course, from my prospect point, I always add something that I think as an expert they also need to know. So I combine that, what they want, they told me that they want to learn, until combined with the as an expert, I think they need to know that as well. So I combined all of that, and the PDF was pretty much, the PDF was like 5 or 6 page long. So it was the graphic out there, it was the text itself out there, it was specific examples out there, it was like a combination of everything. And the coolest part, guys, so everyone who were purchasing that PDF from me, and the coolest part about that, because they were end up on my list. And then when they end up on my list, I took it to the next level. And the next level, I was started sending emails and say, hey guys, if you're interested, first of all, join my Facebook group for free, more stuff. And, you know, and if you're not in my group, you should be there. But join my Facebook group. And if you are actually looking for one-on-one coach, then schedule the call with me. Because the coolest part, because the people actually experience, like, they experience my low-cost product, they found it's very interesting, they're very powerful. Remember that, you know, it's not about how much you pay, it's about how much you get. Like, if I, honestly, if I pay $50 for PDF and I get everything from A to Z to specific topic, yeah, I do want to save the money and pay $17. But at the same time, you know, like, if I know that that PDF is freaking awesome, I will come, I have this like good experience, and I will come back to that person and I want to buy more. And because I created with that PDF, I create the trust even better. Then lots of people actually were scheduling the call with me, and I actually get my first one-on-one client. It was very, very cool. So that's how it's worked. So my first money, that's how I did that. I actually literally just create PDF based off the what ideal clients wanted, added a little more, then they end up on my list, and then I took it to the, it's kind of a funnel, you take it to the next level, because before you pitch your big price, pitch your slow price, like low price. And because low is no problems, it's low price, it's easy because people have no problems to sell, like to buy low cost product, they have no problems. Like, I will pay $9, $20, you know, something slow for the good value, I have no problems to buy. It's much harder to convince somebody, like, invest couple thousands dollars in your service if they never experienced your value before. So it's much, much harder. So if you have struggles to actually, like, making your first sales, or, you know, like, you make your first sales, but you're not sure, you know, how to take it to the next level, sell your low-cost product because it will boost your confidence, because you will feel that like, hey, I received the money, it feels good to me. This is the first one. And second one, to those people who are already purchasing that stuff, convince them to schedule the call with you and see if they need more help from you. Okay? Nice. Okay. So, Angela, I absolutely love that what you just said, that you're going to work on this strategy today. So this is the biggest mistake that I see that people making, and it's not over to you. It's like, just you kind of give me an idea that I see that people making, and I have been there too. Sometimes we kind of wake up in the morning and we're like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna do this. What I want you to do, step back and literally map up everything, because like this, even this strategy, it's a part of the funnel, right? And so map up your strategy, what you want to achieve with this specific strategy, what kind of results you want to achieve. In my case, when I start making that, I actually create like I grabbed a piece of paper and I was like writing down like, you know, this is how much sales I want to make. And the coolest part, because when I was like far away from that number that I want to achieve, I was pushing myself harder. And so I was promoting in my Facebook group, but I also was promoting in my Facebook business page. So somewhere 5 years ago, if you scroll down, you probably will find. But yeah, I was promoting on my Facebook business page, on my Facebook group. Then I was sending emails to my people. At that time, I didn't really have lots of emails on my list. Lots of people on my list, so it was not a big deal for me, but the sales came from Facebook groups. But what I want you to do, guys, literally like write down the strategy, set the specific goal, the goal, how many people you want to achieve, the goal, like how many people you want to sell your service, how much sales you want to make from, you know, from this specific strategy, and what's the final result, what the next step in your business you want to take it. Because low-cost product, it's always have to be, you know, take it to the like a steps to the next level. Yeah, exactly. You step back and you mapping up everything, and then you start working. And always, like I said before, always mapping up, because if it will work out, then you can repeat the same strategy again and again in the future. Somehow I literally just come to that, how I make my first $1,000, because I was like looking out on my calendar and I was checking out how the heck I was doing those first sales, and it's like kind of caught my attention. Okay. So any other questions related to this specific strategy or related to your business, how you can actually make your first cash in your business? You're welcome, guys. Post the questions below and you know, let me answer. Oh, by the way, for those people who are interested, stay tuned. I don't know when it will be, somewhere hopefully this month, but I'm gonna do the training on the first funnels, which is the reason why I brought this topic about the funnels, because it's kind of in my mind right now, because like I see lots of people struggling with the funnels. They like, I know how to do it, but I'm not sure what, like, what can the email send, how often email send, how to convince people to buy from you, how the funnels that look like. So stay tuned for the upcoming training. I don't have sign up page yet. I don't have anything. I just have this idea. If you're interested to, you know, to get your hands on this training about the funnels, you're welcome, comment below, and when it will be time for you guys, I will share it out. But kind of stay tuned, because I am jumping here. Stay tuned, because if you're interested to learn more about the funnel, because I figured out that lots of people are I know lots of people are struggling about the funnels for some reason, not sure why, but I want to guys put the training for you to make it much easier. If you, like I said before, thank you for the hearts, thank you for the love. If you guys new to me right now, make sure you like my Facebook business page and Markets as a C first, because I see that lots of people, I did research, small research on my personal page, that I asked people if they take summer off, and lots of people take summer off. And I want to benefit those people who did not take the summer off, those people still working on the business. I want to benefit for during the summertime. I'm going to deliver lots of free training for you guys to make sure that, you know, you're going to be a time ahead when everybody else come back from vacations. So it's going to benefit you guys big time. Okay, any questions related to the strategy, how to make your first sales in the business? I'm gonna throw the over the questions that I got in the Facebook group and see if people ask me there too. Okay, somebody asked, how did I promote it and where? I was promoting in my Facebook group. I was promoting in my Facebook business page. I was promoting in other Facebook groups, but after I was building relationship with the people inside of the group because I didn't want to kick out from the group. Yeah, very clear, as always. I always deliver pretty clear. You know that, right? Okay. Hold on, one of the questions I got, let me check it out. Hold on guys, one of the questions I got and I lost the question. It went to other folder, I need to find that other folder. I have no idea how to find that in the other folder. Anyway, I can't find the other folder. There was a couple questions I got in the other folder and I forgot and I missed it. Oh well, the people will watch the replay, so it will be okay. Okay, any other guys questions? Very cool, we actually did the training within 30 minutes, that's very awesome. Okay, so here is the deal. Looks like I cannot find any other questions. Looks like everything's clear, everything's fine. So if you have questions after that, post the questions below. We'll come back after a while and check it, make sure there will be no questions. Otherwise, guys, stay tuned for the upcoming training about the funnels. If you're interested to set your first funnel and make sure that funnel in convinced into your, you know, to yourselves, to your paid clients. And that's it. Make sure you join our Facebook group, Savvy Action Taker Entrepreneur. And thank you so much. Oh, you're so welcome. Yeah. Awesome. You're so welcome. We are done for now. And guys, make sure you like my Facebook business page. And I will see you in our Facebook group, Savvy Action Tech Entrepreneur. Thank you so much for being part of, you know, of this chain. Thank you so much for all your questions. And looking forward to see you for upcoming training. See you in my upcoming training, how to set your first funnel. So if you are interested to set your first funnel, figure out how it's look like, what kind of mistakes you need to avoid, how to set this from A to Z, then stay tuned for that training is coming. And I love you guys. Thank you so much for, you know, for following me. Bye.